In 794, Vikings from the fjords of western Norway sailed across the North Sea, first to the Shetland Islands, then south to Orkney. Then they sailed down between the outer and inner Hebrides, off the Atlantic coast of Scotland, probably attacking every settlement they found along the way, and probably set up some bases. We don't have any direct records for this, except all the islands of Britain were devastated in 794. The first recorded attack on Scotland was at Iona Abbey, on the Isle of Iona, off the west coast of Scotland in 795. Saint Columba, an Irish missionary evangelist, also called Apostle of the Picts, founded a monastery on Iona in 563. The monastery grew into an abbey and was a focal point for the spread of Christianity throughout Scotland, and marks the foundation of a monastic community by Saint Columba. The Vikings landed on the island, killed some monks and took all the treasure they could find, and torched the place. This would not be the last time this abbey would get attacked. They sailed further south and arrived at the island of Rathlin, off the Antrim coast in Ireland's northeast corner. The island had a church which the Vikings plundered and set on fire. In the annals of Ulster it says, "The raid was marked by the pillaging of the island's church, and the burning of its buildings, and its shrines were broken and plundered." This is the first recorded Viking raid in Ireland. Then they might have split up, one group sailing down the west coast and one sailing down the east coast. The west coast party sailed close to the coast of Northern O'Neill and found a monastery on the island of Inishmurry. The monastery on Inishmurry is said to have been founded around 520 by Saint Molaise. The Vikings attacked, looted and set the church and monastery on fire, returned to their ships with their treasure and sailed further down the west coast of Ireland. Meanwhile, the east coast party arrived at Lembeh Island just off the coast of not yet founded Dublin, where the monastery of Saint Comcil was situated. The settlement, church and monastery were built in 530 by the same monk Saint Columba who founded Iona Abbey and some 30 other monasteries in Ireland. The Vikings plundered and burned the church and monastery to the ground, and probably killed some monks too while they were at it. On the west coast, the Vikings had reached the island of Inishbofin. The island had a monastery that was founded around 665 by Colman of Lindisfarne. They landed the longships on the beach, went up to the monastery and sacked it, killed some monks, or maybe all of them, and burned it down. The year 795 was devastating for the Irish Christian Church and must have been an extremely lucrative undertaking for the pagan Vikings. With their longships filled to the brim with gold and silver, the Northmen sailed back to their bases in Norway or northern Scotland. In 796, all that is recorded in the Irish Chronicles is "Heathens are in Ireland." In 798, the Vikings returned, and this time they found St. Patrick's Island. The monastery of St. Patrick's Island was most likely founded by St. Patrick, known as the Apostle of Ireland. He is the primary patron saint of Ireland, the missionary who had brought Christianity from England to pagan Ireland. The Vikings pillaged and burned the monastery, and hopefully killed all the monks. The Irish Chronicle says, "St. Patrick was burnt by the Vikings. The cattle tribute of the territories was carried away. They took the relic of St. Mochonna, and the shrine of St. Mochonna was broken by them." The Irish Chronicles also says that there were many raids on both Ireland and Britain that year, and that they took many riches and great booties, but no place names except for the Isle of Man, that the Vikings attacked for the first time. With their ships filled up with treasure, they sailed back to their bases. By 802, the Columban monks on Iona Island had rebuilt the abbey and started preaching lies again about a dead Jew nailed to a cross. The Vikings was not pleased by this, so they attacked, looted and burned down the abbey for the second time. They returned to their ships and sailed back to where they came from. When the Vikings sailed by Iona Island in 806, they couldn't believe their own eyes. The monks had again rebuilt the abbey and started preaching lies again about the Jew that is supposed to have died for our sins. The only sin here is lying about nature, namely that this Jew Jesus was born by the Jewish Virgin Mary, and at the same time Jesus was the son of the Jewish childbearing God Yahweh that had raped his mother. Jesus, what a story. Oh, sorry. By Thor, the Vikings could not let this stand. They had to set an example that lying about nature is not acceptable. So after they burned the monastery, the Vikings massacred 68 monks in what is today known as Martyrs Bay, named by the event. Now this scared off many of the surviving Columban monks, who relocated to the new Columban Abbey of Kells in Ireland. The Vikings took all of value and sailed back home. By 807, the monks of Inishmurry had rebuilt the monastery and continued to indoctrinate the population with Christianity. The Vikings came by, looted, killed monks, and set the monastery on fire. They sailed further south to check if the monks had rebuilt the monastery of Inishbofin. They had not, or at least it's not recorded in any of the Irish chronicles. But they did find a settlement a little further south, at Roscam in County Galway, that the Vikings pillaged, and of course they burned down the church. For about 2 decades, the Vikings confined their activities to coastal settlements. Raiding parties were generally small, and there is no evidence that any of them wintered in Ireland during this early phase of hit-and-run activity. Typically, the Vikings would arrive at a settlement without warning, plunder what goods and people they could. The people were usually sold as slaves, though notable personages were often held for ransom, before retreating to their Scandinavian or Scottish bases. While most Irish counterattacks on the Vikings met with defeat, a few succeeded. The Ulaid clan defeated a band of Viking raiders in 811, and a band was defeated in Connacht in 812, and one in Munster around the same time. But the next year, in 813, the Irish Annals refers to a battle where the Vikings had slaughtered the Irish and killed the local king of Connacht. These Viking setbacks might have contributed to a period of calm of 8 years, when there are no attacks on Ireland recorded in the annals. But the Vikings were just warming up and would return with a vengeance. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel and I will create more. Thank you for listening.